Hey nerds, Bevan here. Welcome back to my channel. I know it's been a while. I haven't been very good in the month of September for putting up videos, but I'm back. So hit that subscribe button because I'm very close to 200 now, finally. And when I do hit that, there's a giveaway. Again, I'm still working on what's going to be in the giveaway, but there's going to be some comics, some toys, some other goodies. It's going to be a good giveaway, but you got to be subscribed. So hit that subscribe button now. I'm very passionate about my giveaway. I'm very passionate about my channel. I'm very passionate about statue collecting, specifically Kotobukiya, Kia, which the majority of these statues behind me are. I got 8 out of these 9. These 3 over my shoulder here. I love Kotobukiya, so that's what I'm talking about today. Kotobukiya hasn't put out a whole lot recently this year that I've been super interested in. As a matter of fact, I think the stuff they've been putting out, while it hasn't appealed to me, has also been very overpriced. So I haven't gotten anything from them this year. However, that's gonna change in 2020 because they have some fire statues coming out next year. First, let's talk about the most recently revealed Rise of Skywalker Star Wars artifacts. So they're coming out with a BB-8. And a Rey. And a Kylo Ren. Now these are all awesome, although I don't really love the pose of Rey, like looking over her shoulder, like getting that booty shot in, but it's still like an awesome statue. I was kind of doing a toss up between getting these and getting like the SH Figuarts action figures, but like my heart is with statues, so I'm gonna be getting all 3 of these for Rise of Skywalker. Speaking of Skywalker, they are putting out a Luke Skywalker X-Wing Pilot Edition, and this thing looks awesome. Luke Skywalker is not my favorite character by any means. He's not really even close, but I'll be getting the statue because it's awesome. Now I expect these to be in that, like, again, this is a Canadian channel, so all my prices aren't Canadian, so keep that in mind when I'm saying them. Like the Justice League figures that came out a couple years ago were all like $100 each, Canadian. So I'm hoping these are like a little bit less, although these are more dynamic, so it's really hard to say, like especially those Rise of Skywalker ones. But if they're in like that $100 range, I'll probably get all of them. Like I'll get the BB-8, the Rey, the Kylo Ren, and the Luke Skywalker, all for about $100 each. Holy shit, that's expensive. But then let's flip over to the Marvel side of things. I do have a nice selection of Marvel. The first one we'll talk about is the Bishiju, the Dark Phoenix they're putting out. This is version 2 of the Dark Phoenix. Now this thing looks great. I have a Jean Grey already, although Jean Grey is like not high on my favorite character list, but like that version of the Jean Grey is phenomenal. Like it completely takes the essence of that 1992 cartoon Jim Lee version of Jean Grey and just like puts it in plastic form. I think it's like the best I've ever seen in that scale anyway, of like a physical representation of that cartoon comic character. That's the only Marvel one so far. I have a lot of Marvels, so like I'm pretty good there. Unless I start putting out some more classics of like X-Men or like another Spider-Man that they might do. But flipping over to DC, there's a few on the DC side that I really want, including this Bishiju Poison Ivy. I love Poison Ivy. She's one of my favorite Batman villains, like right up there with Riddler and Catwoman and Penguin. Probably because Uma Thurman played her in the that 90s movie. Oh, and I love that movie because Arnold Schwarzenegger as Mr. Freeze is fucking amazing. So there's her. And then the other Batman villain I want to get is this ArtFX Batman Who Laughs. I haven't read Metals, I haven't read Batman Who Laughs, but like this statue is awesome. Out of all the ones on the list, this might be the one I would be least likely to pick up, even though it's amazing. It's just because I don't have the attachment to that character like I do all the other ones on this list. But the one that's a slam dunk that I will for sure be getting, the only one that like comes close, is the Rey from Star Wars, and that's this ArtFX Nightwing. Nightwing is one of my favorite comic book characters of all time, for sure top 5. He's right up there with Batman on the DC side, and like way ahead of Flash, who would come third for DC. The only reason I wouldn't get this Nightwing is if I find that DC collectibles Jim Lee version before him, because that thing is killer. That the DC collectibles version is Reason versus the PVC that Kotobukiya uses. So like that would also go in a different section of the house, because I keep my Reason statues. I only have one. In the glass cases out in the living room, and the PVC in here in the toy room slash office. So those are a whole bunch of statues I want to get from Kotobukiya in 2020. Let's see, there was the four Star Wars, and then the Dark Phoenix for Marvel, and the three Batmans. So that's eight statues I might need to get, all probably in that $100 range. Don't tell my girlfriend and don't show her this video. Just please don't. I want to be able to get this stuff. I'm gonna have to like get a second job or something. Oh, I've actually been thinking about getting a second job, and like I am getting a second job at some point just so I can have a monthly toy budget. Comment below some of your favorite pieces you own already. Comment below what you're most looking forward to, like I just did. Don't forget to hit subscribe, because like I said at the beginning of the video, there's a giveaway once I hit 200 subscribers. You can follow me on Instagram and Twitter at Bevan Boychuk. And until next time, folks, I will see you next time.